Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to BlackCatsNetwork.com. Today we come to you from Gorville High School and Justin Dale Shadows Memorial Field for a non-conference matchup featuring the Black Cats of Gorville and the Pharaohs of Egyptian. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Brian Murley. Thank you for joining us here today on this gorgeous sunny day. Just a little chilly out there. The wind has died down compared to the last few days. The Black Cats come in off of a victory Monday night against the Hawks of Gallatin County, where they won 15-2 in a short game affair after losing two this week in the Pleasant Plains 5-1, and the Red Devils of Murfreesboro 11-10 in walk-off fashion for the Red Devils. Black Cats looking to bounce back. Tonight will be a doubleheader. They will take on Egyptian here in this first game. Then we'll take a pause. And then restart a second broadcast for the second game as they take on the Apple Knockers of Cobden. Tomorrow night, Black Cats will be on the road as they play at Mountain Dew Park for the Spring Fling. I believe that game time is at 5:30. JR and I will not have that game. We will be bringing you the girls' game tomorrow as they take on the Red Devils, Lady Red Devils of Murfreesboro. But earlier start time tonight, the game is going to start here. As soon as teams get done with the infield, supposed to start at 4, probably going to be more like 4:05 or so, as the Black Cats are just finishing up infield here, and the Pharaohs have yet to take infield. JR is still at golf practice. He'll be on his way as soon as he possibly can. He'll probably be here, I would imagine, around the third inning or so. That's where we're at. So with that in mind, we're going to take a break. We're going to hear a word from our sponsors, because without our sponsors, none of this would be possible. We try to bring you as much action as we can. If you joined me Saturday night, you saw the Finding Nemo Jr. play. If you've not watched that yet, you need to go back and check it out on YouTube or Facebook or the BlackCatsNetwork.com. It was a great production, and Miss Barb Stanley and Miss Dana Harris did a phenomenal job with her cast, and I hope you all could check that out. But I'm going to take a break, because JR can't take a break. Because he's not here, but you're watching the Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com, a free service of Gorville School. Like more information, contact us on our Facebook page or email us at BlackCatsNetwork@gmail.com or contact@GorvilleSchools.com. I'll be back in about 5.5 minutes. You're watching the Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com.
Southern Trust Bank is the only bank in Johnson County that is locally owned. Community banks touch every corner of our lives. They support us as we turn our life's goals into accomplishments. Goals like going to college, opening a small business, buying a home, planning a wedding, or having a baby. For your first car to life after retirement, our community bank is there for all your life's milestones. Southern Trust Bank is located in Gorville, Vienna, and Marion. Come out and visit the friendly faces at your local branch. FDIC Equal Housing Lender. Black Cat alum Noel Pease is proud to have his company, Pease Contracting LLC, support the Black Cat Network. Noel can handle any and all of your needs when it comes to lawn care, landscape, snow removal, or excavation. Reach out to Noel at 618-364-5140 for a free estimate. For grass, gravel, snow, or dirt, use Pease Contracting at a price that won't hurt. Don't get caught late in the game and find yourself running out of your stuff in advance. Visit the Oasis, conveniently located just north of Gorville on Route 7. The Oasis, as well as supporting your Gorville Black Cats. Remember, everything sells with Harper. Have you got a commercial or home project that requires more equipment and muscle than you have available? Well, you don't have to break your back to get the job done. You can save time and money with Suits Equipment Rental. Suits Equipment Rentals has all the tools and equipment you'll need to tackle any project, big or small. Call them today at 618-992-4433. Timber! If you have a need for attention to any tree issues on your property, Shawnee Tree Services is here to help. The folks at Shawnee Tree Services are arbor care specialists, providing all types of tree services for Johnson County and the surrounding areas. Whether it's a simple tree trimming or complete removal, Shawnee Tree Service has the answer for you. Contact them today at 618-694-6343. Why would you call anyone else? Once again, Wiffle Boys Pizza is the official pizza of the Black Cats Network. The Southern Illinois original, located in the heart of downtown Gorville, offers pizza, subs, salads, soups, wings, and appetizers. You can place your order the old-timey way by phone at 618-995-9433 or order online. Download the Wiffle Boys app, available through Android and iOS, and look in the Apple Store or Google Play. They've also added a lunch menu and are open for lunch Wednesdays through Sunday at 11 o'clock. Call them now at 618-995-9433. Wiffle Boys Pizza, hometown, homegrown, and always homemade.
Gorville has a new option for a home-cooked breakfast or lunch at the Gorville Grill, located behind H&H Fuel across from Wiffle Boys. The Gorville Grill offers a full breakfast and lunch menu, including biscuits and gravy, the Black Cat Burger, and homemade pies. They are open Monday through Friday from 6 to 2 and Saturday 6 to 11. Call ahead at 618-964-0105, and you can pick up your meal at their drive-thru. Check out their daily lunch specials posted on their Facebook page, The Gorville Grill. Friendly service, quality food, and made with love. Thank all our sponsors. And, yeah. We are just getting pretty close to the start of this ball game. Gorville's done with their infield. Now Egyptians taking theirs. Theirs won't be as long as they only got 9 players today. It's their spring break, and 5 of their players are on not here. So that'll make it for an interesting thing. Here you go, Miss Jenna. Miss Jenna's going to do my stuff until JR gets here. And hopefully he'll be rolling in before around 4:30 or so. Looks like the first pitch is probably going to be around about 4:07. Hey, we're running on ESPN time. Actually, 4:05 would be first pitch if we were doing ESPN time, but I don't think we're going to make that. We still have the coaches meeting to go. Black Cats come in at 4-3 with losses to DuCoin, Murfreesboro, and Pleasant Plains. And then Egyptian comes in at 0-3 or 0-4, I believe. They were supposed to have played yesterday, but they got rained out. They were supposed to have played Meridian yesterday and were rained out. And former SEC foe. So tonight, like I said, it's going to be a doubleheader, us here against Egyptian here in this first ball game. And then we'll stop this broadcast and then start a second broadcast, which will then feature us against Cobden. So that's the plans for tonight. And, yeah. So right now you can sit back and watch this infield as I get ready to do my PA stuff here on BlackCatsNetwork.com. We're so glad you guys are with us tonight. If you can, the weather's starting to get a little nicer, starting to get a little warmer. You might start thinking about coming out to the ballpark. Today the girls are at home as well. They're playing the Lady Wildcats of Anna Jonesboro, if you'd like to go check them out. And like I said, tomorrow they'll also be home and take on the Lady Red Devils of Murfreesboro, which should be a really good ball game. Lady Red Devils have a young lady who's 9. She's a senior. Can't remember her name. She's signed to play with SCU next year. So I will.
Good afternoon, sports fans, and welcome to Gorville Schools in Justindale Shadows Memorial Field, home of the 2-time defending Black Diamond Conference West champion, Gorville Black Cats. The Black Cats take on the Pharaohs of Egyptian in a non-conference matchup. Coaches, players, and fans who follow the New Watch Ryan expectations will represent their school well and create a positive game experience. Represent your school and community through positive interaction with the opposing fans and players. Use positive cheers, chants, songs, or gestures. Display modesty in victory, graciousness in defeat. Respect and acknowledge the integrity and judgment of the officials, and exhibit positive behavior before, during, and after the contest. You're visiting here today with us, Justin Dale Shadows Memorial Field. The bathrooms are located at the concession stand area, which is located behind the first base side. We ask you to please return all foul balls as quickly as possible to either dugout so we get them back in play as soon as possible. And finally, we ask you to help keep the park looking clean and beautiful by placing all your trash in the trash cans located strategically throughout the park. This time, I'd ask everyone to please rise, remove your caps, direct your attention to the flagpole located in center field as we honor America, the playing of our national anthem. Today's gamer, Mr. Jerry Suits and Mr. Jim Suits. Now, let's get the start line first for your Gorville Blackcats. Leading off and behind the plate today, number 26, Nick Gower. Batting second and playing second base, number 5, Hunter Francis. Batting third and playing center field, number 2, Tyler Suits. Batting fourth and playing shortstop, number 4, Drake Moss. On the hill today for the Blackcats, number 18, Nick Lingle. Your designated hitter, number 31, Gary Church. Batting sixth and playing third base, number 12, Cole Tripp. Batting seventh and playing first base, number 33, Levi Damon. Batting eighth and playing right field, number 11, Drake Buffington. And batting ninth and playing left field, double zero, Grant Rock. Start out for the Pharaohs behind the plate, batting first, number 7, Josh McKee. On the hill for the Pharaohs today, number 17, Jacob Webb. Batting third and playing first base, number 44, Keaton Pyramid. Batting fourth and playing third base, number 63, Scotty Jones. Batting fifth and playing second base, number 33, Will Razan. Batting sixth and playing shortstop, double zero, Xander Benet. Batting seventh and playing center field, number 4, Logan Johnson. Batting eighth and playing left field, number 50, Elijah Price. And batting ninth for playing right field, number 2, Jimmy Easton. Thank you. up top the first inning for the Pharaohs, the catcher number 7, Josh McKee.
Well, there you have the starting lineups. Josh McKee, Nick Lingle on the hill. Nick Lingle for the first pitch. He hits ready. He delivers. First pitch is a ball outside. Excuse me. Nick Lingle getting the start on the hill today. A little bit different lineup here today. He's moving some people around on this doubleheader day. That ball swing and a miss. Strike one. One ball, one strike to Mr. McKee. Pitch from Lingle. Strike two on the outside corner. One ball, two strikes. Lingle gets the sign, working from the stretch. Fires, delivered ball down and outside, two and two. Not a bad location on a 1-2 pitch. Lingle delivers, ball high. Run the count full. Lingle gets the sign. Ball down and one. Pitch number 8 on its way from Nick Lingle. There's the pitch. Ball high. Two balls, no strikes. That ball's fouled, out of play, strike one. That ball's lifted foul, strike two. Two balls, two strikes. Lingle trying to get the first out of the inning. Ball down in the dirt. Full runs the count full. First two batters runs the count full too. Let's see if he can get a little bit different result this time. First time he walked the batter. Lingle comes set. Runner is going. Swing and a miss. Oh. Went to throw and the guy kind of stepped right in front of him.
Now batting for the Pharaohs, first baseman number 44, Keaton Pierman.
Let me swing it better. I don't think so.
All right, let's go, Bars! Let's go!
One away, runner at second base. It brings up Keaton Pierman. Lingle delivers. Ball outside. Ball one. There's a strike. Good location. Like I said, the first couple of pitches just down. He just needs to get the height right. Right at 73 mile an hour, Jenna says. I can't read that from here. Ball out. Two balls and a strike to Pierman. Lingle takes a deep breath. Comes set. Swing and a miss. Took a little bit off that one. Runs the count to 2-2 now. Ball. Full count. Sensing a pattern here. Throwing a lot of pitches in three batters. Here's the swing. Swing and a miss. Strike two, or strikeout number two. That brings up Scotty Goins.
Now batting for the Pharaohs, third baseman number 63, Scotty Goins.
Goins steps in. You got to think with numbers that high, they get to pick their own numbers. 63, 50, There's a strike one. Lingle comes set, delivers to Goins. First breaking ball we've seen from Lingle today. That ball is high. One ball, one strike. Seen a changeup. That was the first breaking ball we've seen. Beautiful day. Still a little chilly. People still in sweatshirts and blankets. There's a strike two. Some people in igloos. Greenhouses. Lingle comes set. Oh, big sweeping curveball. Ball two. Oh, ball down. Good pitch, though. Good, great pitch. Another full count. Four batters, four full counts. That gets your pitch total up in a hurry. Here's the pitch from Lingle. Ball down in the dirt, walks him. That brings up Will.
Now batting for the Pharaohs, the second baseman, number 33, Will Lazar.
Will Lazar steps in with runners at first and second, two away. Let's do something different and not go full count this time. That ball is, that's going to be a wild pitch, and it'll move the runners up. Ball one. Well, that's one thing we had. I said, so do something different. He did. He threw it to the backstop. Hadn't done that yet today. Nick's location's been good. It's just been, everything's been down a little bit. And that's what you want to do as a pitcher. You want to keep it down, but maybe not that far down. Got to find where Mr. Suits wants the bottom of that strike zone and camp out there. Two balls, no strikes. That ball's high, full count. 3-0. Lingle's got to battle back here. There's a strike. You know he's taking all the way. Just throw it right down the middle. Lingle gets the sign. Oh, good spot. That brings up Xander Benet.
Now batting for the Pharaohs, shortstop 00, Xander Benet.
Even though it's spelled Bean, Coach said it's Benet. He goes, I know it's Bean. Don't say Bean. Or Beanie. There's strike one. Deep breath from Lingle. Runners at every position. No room for him. Ball down in the dirt. Ball one. One ball, one strike. Two away here in the top of the first inning. Pharaohs and the Black Cats. There's a strike. One ball, two strikes. Got him.
Pharaohs get no runs on no hits, no errors with two left on base as we head to the bottom of the first.
Thank you.
With us about the first inning for your Black Cats, the catcher number 26, Nick Gower.
Nick Gower leading off the bottom of the inning after that put out at home plate after the bad throw back to the pitcher. First pitch of the ball. On the hill, Barrows number 17, Jacob Webb. Whoa, that ball's behind Gower. Ball two. That ball is hit to the shortstop. And that's going to be an error. E3 or 4 or 6. That was shortstop, wasn't it? It's shortstop. Runner goes. Ball outside with the stolen base is Gower. Runner at second base. Hunter Francis up to bat. Here's the pitch from Webb. Oh, gets ready in the back. Hits him right square in the back. Tyler Suits up to bat. Runner at first and second. Nobody out. Tyler squares. There's a strike. That allows, for some reason, Hunter did not run to second base. As Gower gets the third. Hunter Francis with a big lead over there. I will apologize, folks. I'm doing a lot of stuff over here, so I'm not going to be able to move the camera like JR does. And they take the out at home, drives in a run, and one.
Hold up, son. Number three, the Black Cat. Shortstop number four. Drew Wright.
RBI for Tyler Suits. Hunter Francis cruises into third base with no thought at all from the catcher throwing down there. That ball's fouled. Just out of play. Strike one. Or strike two, I'm sorry. No balls, two strikes to Drake Moss. One away, runner at third. Ball inside. Yesterday, or Monday at the girls' game, that would have been a strike. The dude's strike zone was about as big as those two batter boxes put together. Here's the delivery from Webb. That ball's lifted out to right, or that ball's just carrying, and that's going to be a drop fly ball. And that's going to be another run.
Now
for your Black Cats, designated hitter number 31, Garrett Church. Yeah, double thumbs down on that one. Moss gets on by a two-base error. He just takes off for third, and he's there. 2-0 here with one away. Garrett Church up to bat. Garrett Church DH in this game. That ball is, he was out in front of it, swings on it and fouls it away. One ball, one strike. I'll try to turn that a little bit. Like I said, I'm not going to be able to turn the camera like JR does because I'm over here doing 17 things at once. But you got a runner down there at third. Church, here comes the pitch. That ball is fouled. And weak effort there by everyone involved. Strike two. One ball, two strikes. I don't know why my computer keeps... going to sleep here. That ball is fouled down out of play. Yeah, I don't know. It shouldn't. Let's see. Ball inside. That ball has some pop on it. Two balls, two strikes, one away. Runner at third base. Trying to add to the black lead. Pitch. Swung on, foul back. Out of play. Oh, I moved that. Okay, now I know where that
is. Now, Black Cats. Third baseman number 12, Cole Tripp.
Cole Tripp steps in. Runner at first and third. One away. There goes Garrett Church. Hey, and we've learned not to swing the bat when our guys are just taking off running to second. That's a good thing.
Hey, Brian.
Hey, JR.
Hey, Black Cat Nation. You didn't throw me under the bus there for being a little
Not your
late
fault.
There.
You didn't change the start game time.
No kidding.
That ball is ripped to right to left field.
I showed up just
field.
In time.
Oh.
Over the left fielder's head.
That's going to be two runs there. I mean, you got
he's going
to
go for third, and he's going to get third on the aggressive base running.
Thunder, heavy rain, fill a line between joy and pain. It's a long, strange trip, it's all insane. You ain't never going to hear Black Cats. First baseman, number 33, Levi Davis.
See, Levi understands how to wait to let his walk-up music
Absolutely.
Play.
Absolutely. He's all about the timing.
Get these freshmen that just jump in there. Oh, I didn't hear my walk-up song. Yeah, because you jumped in there before I even started the song. What are we up or down? Yeah. Still looking for our first hit. Two
really?
Balls. Yeah. We've scored four runs on three errors.
So it's been a day where you just put the ball in play.
Yeah. Well, they are missing five starters.
Oh, my.
Or five players because of spring break. And the coach did. I said, is there anything I can get for you, anything I can do for you, before I head back to the press box? I don't know if I should say this on air. I probably shouldn't.
Okay.
I'll tell you off air. Why is my computer continuing to go into sleep mode and it shouldn't be?
There's a pop-up in the infield. Is it going to stay in? Pitcher's over. Catcher's over and makes a grab.
The play.
And nobody covering the plate. And we're going to.
Great heads up.
Yes, it was.
That's actually an RBI. It's a sack fly. P2 sack fly. How about that?
One more coin for the Cats. Oh.
Number for your Black Cats. Right fielder number 11, Drake Buffington.
Go into the sleep mode and it shouldn't because I've got all that stuff shut off.
Maybe it's just tired.
Maybe it is. But
this is the first time all year, Brian, we've sat in this booth, looked at dead center field, and those flags have been dead flat.
Yeah.
Almost.
Well, now you show up, the wind starts blowing.
Well, yeah. Pitch up and high for ball one.
Yeah, I feel bad that I didn't get Drake's music, but you know, I had to restart my computer. I don't know. Of course, his computer is very old.
That one bounces across for ball two. Beautiful day out there today.
Yeah.
You know, it was 56 yesterday, and it felt like 30. And it's 56 today, and it feels like 70.
Yep.
Southern Illinois weather.
That ball's fouled out of play.
That one misses outside. Pushes the count to 3-1. Two outs.
There it comes. Here's the pitch. Ball down in the dirt. That brings up Grant Kroc.
Number three, Black Cats, 00. The left fielder, Grant Kroc.
Yeah, I don't know what the dealio is here. Buffington running.
Oh, Buffington
on the run.
Swing and a miss, strike one.
All right, hopefully this boots back up.
That one's going to scoot. Buffington's going to get down to third now on the pass ball. Two balls and a strike.
Here's the pitch from Webb. Foul ball, strike two.
Is that the Suits brothers we got out there today?
Yep.
Jim and Jerry Suits, finer gentlemen you'd never, ever, ever run across. Been officiating for a
very long time.
Long time.
That ball got away.
Yeah, he held on to that just a little bit too long.
That runs the count to full. Swing and a miss. That'll be three outs, right?
It would be three outs right there on the put out from the catcher. Black Cuts put up a crooked number five there in the bottom of the first inning. You're watching the BlackCatNetwork.com. We'll be back with second inning action.
Coming off the top of the second inning for the Pharaohs, shortstop double zero, Xander Bonet.
Lingle with 32 pitches in the first inning. Comes back with the first ball strike. That's very good.
Ooh, that one misses up and in.
One ball, one strike. Those need to go back in my bag.
That one in there. Strike two.
Second time Bonet has faced Lingle. Bonet was up to bat when we got the play out at home to end the inning. There's a strike looking.
Now buddy for the Pharaohs, center fielder number four, Logan Johnson.
Logan Johnson steps in. So how was it out on the golf course today, Jerry?
It was a beautiful day. Actually, we never made it to the course. Today was another day for short practice, so we spent that time, valuable time on the practice green today.
I thought you were going to say you spent it in the clubhouse.
No.
Swing and a miss, strike one.
Lots of putting today.
Lots of putting.
That's where your score happens.
Ball out. Two balls and a strike.
Lingle decided he didn't like the ball.
I guess so.
He'll get it back.
Yeah.
That's what I think is kind of funny about high school. When they ask for another one, you're going to get it back.
Yeah, you're eventually going to. Yeah, it's not like we have, you know, unlimited resources. There's like four balls that use the entire game. One ball or two balls, two strikes to Johnson. Elijah Price waits on deck. Here's the pitch. Ball high. Full count. Lingle faced five and a half batters in the first inning, and four of those he went full count on. The other one he went 3-1.
Wow.
A lot of pitches.
So he's around the plate. He's just
He's got good location. It's just everything's down, too far down for Mr. Suits' liking.
Now batting for the Pharaohs, left fielder number 50, Elijah Price.
Elijah Price steps in. Lingle looks over to first. Delivers. Ball high. Shoulder flying open a little bit there for Lingle. Reason the ball flying high on him. Swing and a miss, strike one.
So did you decide we're doing two separate broadcasts today? All right.
Yep.
Be sure and stick around for tonight's Twilight doubleheader ball game. Following completion of this one, the Apple Knockers of Cobden will come to town.
Ball down in the dirt. Two balls, one strike. Two balls, one strike. Lingle comes set. Delivers. Ball high.
Snap throw down to first. Not in time.
Runs the count to 3-1.
That one in there for strike two. Full count, 3-2.
Another full count from Lingle. That's his sixth full count and eight batters.
Wow.
And got him looking
on that one.
That'll bring up Jimmy Easton.
Now batting for the Pharaohs, right fielder number two, Jimmy Easton.
Jimmy Easton steps in, runner at first, Logan Johnson. Pitch right down the middle, strike one. Maybe you heard me.
coaching, man. I see we've anticipated that we're going to have a second game and already turned the lights on, too. I'm impressed by that.
Yeah, I told Jen, and Jen asked us, should I go ahead and turn them on? I said, go ahead, because we'll probably forget. There's the pitch from Lingle. Ball down in the dirt. Oh,
runner goes late.
There he goes.
Here comes the throw down. Oh,
yeah,
sails.
Good throw would have had
center field. Yep.
Got to give that an E too. Because a good throw has him.
Yeah, no doubt. He hesitated on the pass ball.
Ball outside. 2-2.
Strike three. So Lingle works his way out of the inning. We'll go to the bottom of the second here on the BlackCatNetwork.com. Egyptian Pharaohs and the Black Cats from Gorville. Black Cats lead 5-0.
Nick Gower.
Black Cats go back to the top of the lineup. What did Mr. Gower do last time?
He got on by an error and scored.
There's one lifted to right.
He's
going
to get on
right.
by an error and score.
Right fielder.
That's going to be a hit.
Yeah,
that's over
that
his
ball
head.
Carried.
Should have been caught, probably so, but it never got touched, so we're going to give that a hit. Actual first hit of the game.
Gower with the stand-up double to lead off.
He got in there way too soon. You got to give me time.
There goes Gower on the steal. Yeah, little catcher's indifference there. He clearly had that stolen.
Got to give me time to play, man. Ball one. Hunter Francis with a hit by pitch last time and a run scored. Swing and a miss. Strike one. JR, you got that order ready? We going to order about the...
Figure we'll see how this game plays and get it called in. And the runner takes off from third. You're going to be a play at the plate? Nope. Gower goes in standing up. One more for the Cats. Count moves to 2-1 on Hunter Francis.
Ball outside. 3-1.
Yeah, I figured we'd kind of see how this game plays out. It gets near the end, I'll give a call, place our order, and not do too much on the post game.
Oh, that Look one hurt.
Right off of the shoulder.
Oh, my goodness.
Francis goes down to first on his second hit by pitch. Yeah, now he's leaned. He's bent over now. It's you can kind of hear it up here. I don't know. They got him square on the elbow.
Yeah, I heard it, man. It
kind of thunked.
Yeah, that one hurt. Francis, I'm just going to run all the way around the bases. And
there's
a hit.
Right between the second baseman and or the shortstop and the third baseman. It rolls into the outfield.
Suits is going to go to second.
Throw comes in to Coach Tripp. Nope. He got out of the way. Came into third. Suits goes down to second. Runners at second and third. Nobody out.
Hold up. Sandwell. Now ready for the Blackcaps. Shortstop number four. Drake.
No. I think advanced on the throw to third. So.
Yes, it's just a single. Just a single, no error.
That one actually hit off the run. Yeah, a foul ball.
No. No. He was going to be at third anyway. Because he was running on the pitch.
That pitch is going to be lifted.
He's going to miss
maybe
that.
Maybe in no man's land. Right fielder's coming in. He can't get to it.
It's going to be a base hit because he never got there.
And runners will advance 90 feet. Bring a run in for the Black Cats. Suits goes to third. Moss goes to first.
Keep the hands moving. The Black Cats designated hitter, number 31, Carrot.
There goes Moss. There's a ball hit hard down foul territory down the third baseline. Strike one. Egyptian not to be able to record the first out of the inning yet.
Yeah. There goes Moss.
Moss takes off.
That ball's out.
Misses out.
Catcher's indifference. Ding, ding, dong. Church has the opportunity here to drive in a couple of runs with a big base hit here. Fouls that one off. Strike two. Church walked last time on an 8-pitch at bat.
Wow, hanging tough. He likes that. Oh,
my goodness.
Got Trip off the carom. He's laughing about it.
Ouch.
Got him right in the thigh.
Man, with friends like hitting that, hitting baseballs at you, who needs enemies, right?
Man, that was way inside, too. I don't even know how he got his bat on the ball. That one misses away. Two balls, two strikes.
Webb on the mound. Delivers. Ball up.
3-2 your count.
Church ready. Ball inside. Walked him.
We bases loaded for Cole Tripp.
Now that appear Black Cats, third baseman number 12, Cole Tripp.
Cole Tripp steps in. Cole got reached behind an error last time. Base is loaded. There's a ball. Still, Jenna J.R., that strike zone Monday night was about as big as those two batter's boxes combined.
Yeah, you ain't kidding. It was unusually large. Elongated.
Elongated. Oh.
That one gets him. That's going to be an RBI. And one run.
It's going to bring up Levi Damon.
Thunder, heavy rain, thin line between your hand.
Now, better for your Black Cats. First base, then number 33. Levi!
You ain't never be the same. Live life through the night.
See, Levi gets it.
Mm-hmm. That's going to be a ball lifted to center field. Unable to make the catch. Falls down, ball comes in. Runners are just going to advance one spot.
It's going to be an E8.
Pushes the score now to 9-0.
Number for your Black Cats, right field number 11. Strike Buffita.
And we got a timeout here. Egyptian's going to gather the troops and chat about it. I don't know if he's going to make a change here at this point, or juncture or not. Looks like he's going to stay with Webb. Just some words of encouragement.
Yeah. I mean, he's not pitching bad. He's getting our guys to make contact. They just, unfortunately, can't catch the ball.
Yeah, having difficulties gathering it. Yeah, I believe the Apple Knockers. Actually, I saw the Apple Knocker bus earlier at Wiffle Boys on my way in here. I think they stopped in to take advantage of the Wednesday Daily Special.
Mm.
Same one we're going to have here soon.
Ball down in the dirt, ball one. 9 runs now for the Black Cats.
That one in there for strike one.
Buffington walked last time at bat and had a stolen base. It was a little early on that one. One ball, two strikes. Nobody out, JR.
Nobody out.
JR's not falling asleep on his job. There is nobody out. Foul ball.
Ground ball. I tell you, that on deck circle is just not a safe spot today.
You got to pay attention. Moss comes out, still has a helmet on.
Yeah.
Moss is expected to bat again.
Pitch misses outside. 2 balls, 2 strikes.
That ball is ripped. That could be
ripped and driven. It's going to empty the bases. 1 bounce, 2 bounce rolls to the fence. Levi Damon, here he comes, trucking towards third base, and Coach Tripp's going to hold him up. Two out, bases loaded, double for Drake Buffington.
Somebody for your Black Cats. Left fielder, double zero.
Grant Kroc now. See if he can move Buffington along. Nobody holds Buff on. He's taking off for third.
No, you got Levi down there.
Oh, that's right. I forgot we had Levi out in front of him.
Levi was running with all he had, man. He was trying. 2 balls, no strikes.
Didn't break.
Egyptian only has 9 players with him today, so.
Not a lot of options for the Pharaohs.
Ball inside.
This is inside. 3-0.
Now 11-0. There is a strike. That ball's fouled back out of play.
Fills the count up 3-2. Missed inside, ball four. So for the second time this inning, Black Cats back at the top of the order. Nick Gower comes in.
Nick Gower!
This time with bases loaded.
Ball up.
That one misses. Ball two.
Two balls, no strike.
So refresh our memory, Brian. What are the rules on short game? 10 after 4?
No, 15. 12. I think it's 12. 15. If you play high or junior high rules, it's 20 after 3, 15 after 4, 10 after 5. I don't know if that's the same for high school. But swing and a miss. Three balls and a strike. Now, I think Webb's just done.
Yeah. The motivation and effort just seems to be lacking a little bit, and I can't blame him. That one's going to fall in.
That's going to be a hit. Base hit.
Lands in front of the left fielder. Buffington makes a big turn, and coach holds him up.
Base hit, RBI.
Another run for the Black Cats.
Now, ready for your Black Cats. Second baseman, number 5, Hudson Francis.
Ground ball to the shortstop. Oh, I don't know. First.
Got him.
Got him in time. Good play by the shortstop, but brings in a run. That's the first out of the inning.
Nobody for your Black Cats. Center fielder number 2, Tyler Sues.
Takes first pitch high, ball one. Beats that one right up the middle. One runs in. And second run will come in and score. Tyler Suits brings in 2 for the Cats.
Number 4, Black Cat. Shortstop, number 4.
Coach Tripp's got about 9 players down there warming up over on the side.
Yeah.
That one in there for strike 1. Suits sizable lead at first, and Moss takes one for the team. Moves the runners up, first and second. Still only 1 out. Black Cats lead bottom of the second, 15-0 against the Pharaohs of Egyptian. Church looking to add to his average right here.
Francis is the one with the ground out, right?
Correct. To the shortstop.
And then Suits had the base hit. Suits is now second.
There's one going to be in the gap in left field. Going to bring in 1 run. And an RBI for Garrett Church.
Still 1 away.
There's a base hit over the second baseman's head. Drake Moss, who was on the move with the pitch, is going to score easily. Trots in and touches the plate. Makes it 17 to nothing.
Thunder, heavy rain, middle line between Joe. Now gonna be Blackcats. First baseman number 33. Levi Gamer. You ain't never gonna be the same.
Ball outside. Yeah, we're scoring so fast, JR. I don't even have time to color in all the
the
diamonds. Yeah.
Who's still Levi takes one for the team. A lot of hit by pitch today. It's going to fill the bases. Drake Buffington. Buffington put one to the fence last time.
Yeah,
on the
he
roll.
Drove that ball. So we have Moss on third. No, Church is on third. I still haven't caught up.
Church on third, Trip on second. The speedy Levi Damon on first.
There was a ball. Okay, I think I'm caught up.
That one misses inside ball, too. Yeah, Webb looks a little disengaged on the mound right now. That one in there for a strike. Two balls, one strike.
Jen, did that just not put up all the runs until you type it in? Foul ball. Strike dose.
Big swing there by Buffington. He was
looking at
the fence on that one. 2-2 to count, one out.
17, right? Okay. Finally got caught up with all the
takes that one in the middle of the back. I think we have more hit batsmen than we do hits.
I think so.
At this time.
Yeah, the coach is going to come out. We're going to
have a pitching change.
Yeah, we're going to take a break here on the BlackCatsNetwork.com.
Number three, Black Cats. Left fielder, double zero.
So Croc steps in. Lassar comes in from shortstop to take over pitching duties. First pitch misses ball. High, ball one.
Yep.
Only one out here in the bottom of the second. Bases loaded. Black Cats lead 18-0. That one
swing and a miss.
Strike one.
Lazar delivers. Ball inside.
Hey, you reckon we ought to get an extra pizza for the Suits boys?
Can, or I don't know if Sean and Sean's feeding them. They got barbecue up in the...
Oh, yeah, it might be.
And chicken sandwiches. That ball's lifted to center field. That ball's going to get down. They're just playing too deep. And he shuffles or underhands it in. All right, who we got here?
Top of the order.
No, but that ain't.
Well, that's a spot.
That's yours.
15.
Number for the Black Cats. Number 15, Taylor Sims.
Yeah, I'm gonna definitely need this.
Substitutions are starting to flood the lineup now for the Black Cats. He had everybody in that dugout down there warming up.
Yeah, was that scored a run, right?
Yes, it did. First pitch misses high, ball one.
So base hit, RBI. Draw a line there. That's still the second inning. That was a ball one. There's a ball two. Who's on deck? Can you see, Jenna? What number that might?
I was thinking 14, but I can't trust my eyes.
Okay, Lawson, all right. He does have a song.
That pitch misses.
Not a very good song, but he's got a song.
Well, good's all relative, Brian, whether you like it or not.
Well,
right or
wrong. I'm a pretty good judge of music. Just ask me. I'll tell you. Oh!
Swung on. Strike one. That hit the catcher?
I don't know if it hit the catcher, if it hit off Taylor. That must have hit off the catcher's shin guard. Three balls and a strike, one away. Bases loaded, JR. Ball high, walked in. Hey, he gets an RBI. Yeah, I won't play walk it out. That won't be very nice. Who's down? Lawson Land?
Now better for your Black Cats. Number 14, Lawson Land.
Okay, now I see what you mean about the walk-up music.
You think I would steer you wrong. All right. Well, that was a ball. Who's on deck?
26. Nikki.
He does not have a song.
That ground ball to the shortstop. Feels it going to go for the easy out at second.
Smart
they get
play.
It. Yes, it was. Just get the out. Another run will score for the Black Cats. RBI in a field.
That brings
choice.
Up who? Nikki King?
Nikki King.
Number three, your Black Cats. Number 16, Nikki King.
He doesn't have walk-up music?
No.
I'll give him some.
His brother does.
A strike.
Who's on deck? Oh, yeah, I got him one now. 3 weeks late. They can't follow directions.
Pitch misses down and away. Runners stay. 1-1 to count. Two outs.
Runner at first and third.
Lessar looking to finish this up with a third out here. Black Cats lead 21-0 in the bottom of the second inning.
Swing and a miss. Strike two. A
little bit ahead on that one.
I'm not even going to say how many runs we scored at the end. That's just not nice.
A bunch, yeah.
That's just not nice.
That one high. Makes it 2-2. Two outs. Deuces are wild.
Do. Pitch from Lazar. Behind him. Runs the count full.
Runner goes at first.
Swing and a miss.
Swing and a miss. Strike three. And we'll retire the Black Cats. We'll go to the top of the third. Black Cats lead 21-0 here on the BlackCatNetwork.com. Substitutions galore every position with the exception of Lingle on the mound, who comes at the first batter with strike one.
Lady Black Cats 4-0.
Who are they playing today?
Anna Jonesboro. They're Anna pretty good. Jonesboro. AJ's pretty good.
Leads the Lady Black Cats
4-0. On the bottom of the third inning.
Well,
ball outside.
We saw the other night. They can be a come-from-behind team.
Yep. Two balls and a strike to Kendall Webb, who's up to bat for the Lady Black Cats. Two balls and a strike here in the top of the third inning. This might be it. Swing and a miss. Strike two.
So do you think it's 20 after three?
If they're playing by that, I don't know if their coach would want to go anymore, do you think?
I don't think he would. I'm just wondering about calling our dinner in. That one for strike three.
Now batting for the Pharaohs, number 17, Jacob Webb.
Jacob Webb struck out looking his first time up. Lingle now with six Ks. There's a strike.
Throwing pretty hard.
Yeah.
A little pop.
What does that say? Oh, Jenny just missed it. I can see it flashing, but I can't read it. That was 69. Okay, I see. I bet if I put my glasses on, I could probably actually read it, but then I can't read the scorebook if I put the glasses on. Here's the pitch from Lingle. Strike on the inside corner.
Trying to say you're getting old, man.
Swing and a miss. Oh, that ball gets.
Throw to first is
in time.
Put out.
Now batting for the Pharaohs, first baseman number 44, Keaton Pierman.
JR, we were talking about walk-up songs. I forgot my normal flash drive here that I use. I found one in my bag because I had to recut. I had to cut a song for a freshman because, you know, walk-up songs were due 3.5 weeks ago. And he finally asked Jenna to ask me to record a song. But anyway, I found one of our favorites. I found Rhett Schutz's on that thumb drive.
Yes.
I had to play it, you know, Johnny Cash.
I thought it was Johnny Cash.
You're right. Found it.
Waved at and missed on that
one. Strike one. One ball, one strike, two away. It'll be interesting to see what happens here. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike three.
Two.
Well, I'm
one ball, two strikes.
I'm putting him out. I've already written down a strikeout. I'm not.
Well,
gonna
he's got to get
it
now.
I'm not going to erase it now. Told you.
That one in there for strike three.
There's been no runs, no hits, no errors, no one left on base.
We'll be back here on BlackCastNetwork.com.
For the only locally owned bank in Johnson County with locations in Gorville, Vienna, and Marion, visit Southern Trust Bank. Come out and visit the friendly faces at your local bank for all your banking needs. FDIC Equal Housing Lender. Pease Contracting LLC wants to help with any of your landscaping, lawn care, excavation, or snow removal needs. Call Noel Pease at 618-364-5140 today. For grass, dirt, gravel, or snow, Pease Contracting always steals the show. Stop in at the Oasis just north of Gorville on Route 37 for any of your adult beverage needs. If they don't have what you're looking for, just ask Steve and he'll do his best to track it down for you. It's never really a party without the Oasis. The Gorville News exclusively covers all things Black Cats. Contact them at contact@gorvillenews.com with any newsworthy stories about the Gorville and surrounding area. Boasting the best butcher shop department around, as well as full grocery store experience, shop local at the Gorville Food Market, just west of the city park. They're open 7 days a week for your convenience. Going once, going twice, sold. That's the motto at Dean Harper Auction. Reach them at www.deanharperauction.com today for all your auction or estate liquidation needs. Remember, everything sells with Harper. Don't break your back to get a job done. Save time and money with Suits Equipment Rentals. They have all the tools and equipment you need for any project, big or small. Suits Equipment Rentals at 618-992-4433. The folks at Shawnee Tree Service are an arbor care specialist providing all types of tree services for Johnson County and the surrounding areas. Whether it's a simple tree trimming or complete removal, Shawnee Tree Service has the answer for you. Contact them today at 618-694-6343. Why would you call anyone else? For dinner or lunch, stop at Whiffle Boys Pizza today, the official pizza of the Black Cat Network. Now open for lunch Wednesday through Sunday at 11 plus evenings. Whiffle Boys Pizza, hometown, homegrown, and always homemade.
And Gorville has a new option for a home-cooked breakfast or lunch at the Gorville Grill, located behind H&H Fuel across from Whiffle Boys. The Gorville Grill offers a full breakfast and lunch menu, including biscuits and gravy, the Black Cat Burger, and homemade pies. They're open Monday through Friday from 6 to 2, Saturday 6 to 11. Call ahead at 618-964-0105. You can pick up your meal at the drive-thru. Check out their daily lunch specials posted on the Facebook page. The Gorville Grill, friendly service, quality food, and always, just like Brian Murley, made with love.
You're full of something.
Black Cats make short order of game one, 2.5 innings. They retire the Egyptian Pharaohs 21.
And Nick Lingle with a no-hitter.
And a no-hitter for Lingle, 21-0. I'm going to leave you over to Mr. Brian Murley, who's going to give you the game totals while I make a run to one of our sponsors, Whiffle Boys. We're taking advantage of their daily special today. Get yourself a large two-topping pizza and wings.
And wings.
And I'll be right back.
All right. Nick Lingle, like I said, gets the win with a no-hitter today. Only had 8 at-bats against him. 0 for 8. He walked 4 and struck out 6 with 66 pitches. For the Black Cats, Nick Gower, 2 for 3 with 3 runs scored, an RBI and a double, and 2 stolen bases. Taylor Sims, 0 for 1 with an RBI walk. Hunter Francis, 0 for 1 with 2 runs scored, an RBI, 2 hit by pitches, and a stolen base. Lost land 0 for 1 today. Tyler Suits, 2 for 3 with 2 runs scored, 3 RBIs. Nicky King, 0 for 1 with a strikeout. Drake Moss, 1 for 2 with 3 runs scored, an RBI, and a hit by pitch. Garrett Church, 1 for 1 with 3 runs scored, an RBI, and 2 walks. Cole Tripp, 2 for 2 with 3 runs scored, with 2 RBIs and a hit by pitch. Levi Damon, 0 for 1 with 2 RBIs. Sacrifice pop-up to the catcher, which was something else, hit by pitch. Drake Buffington, 1 for 1 with 2 runs scored, 3 RBIs with a double, a hit by pitch, and a walk, and a stolen base. And Grant Kroc, 1 for 2 with a run scored with an RBI, a walk, and a strikeout. Black Cats were 10 of 18 at the plate with 21 runs scored, 15 RBIs, 2 doubles, 5 walks, 2 Ks, one sacrifice, six hit by pitches, four stolen bases. Well, we thank you for joining us here on Black Cats Network. We're going to take a break. Cobden's here. They're going to warm up, stretch, do all that stuff. Our game time schedule start around 6, so I imagine that's probably going to be close to that time that we're going to be starting. But we thank you for joining us. It'll be on a separate broadcast, but we thank you for joining us here on Black Cats Network. Black Cats Network is a free service to Gorville School. Like more information, contact us on our Facebook page or email us at blackcastnetwork@gmail.com or contact@gorvilleschools.com. We'll see you in about half an hour for game number 2 as the Black Cats take on the Apple Knockers here on blackcastnetwork.com.